how many of you actually have a future state in your mind right now? Because it was one of the biggest areas of psychology I was dealing with in clinic work, that people just could not pinpoint their own future, no matter how big or small.
I am a behavioural scientist, which means that I forensically study human behaviour in order to understand and to predict outcomes. So how it is that we behave and why it is that we do what we do.
Who we are at work is not always congruent with who we are at home. So when you are constantly working from home, the person we are becomes a bit blurred. Part of the results of leadership loneliness is the role we tend to play at work and at home.
Resilience is something that you know you have when you need it. So how do you create this state of agility and resilience within yourself and know what it is that you are willing to accept and willing to advocate, rather than sitting in a room full of 10 people seeking permission for agility?
Principles are the same no matter what we're doing. Understand yourself, first and foremost. Then understand the role that you play, and then understand the industry in which you play it. That adapts to a sporting team, that adapts to a corporate executive, that adapts to a middle level management executive. I have to give them the exact behaviours, emotions and brain patterns and self-talk in order to do that succinctly and quickly every single week. And what worked for last week may not work for the next week.
You have to be willing to ask the questions, because if you're not, you're floating down the river denial. And at the other end of the river denial is the concept of, I'm going to now minimize everyone else in my life in order to elevate my own self. That's the next phase.